oxidation catalyst as well to help control those emissions. There's really what we have proposed for continuing for contesting monitoring is going to be using these SIMs for the CO for the carbon monoxide to make an assurance that the oxidation catalyst is working for the VOC as well. Lastly, I want to point out that the major hazardous air pollutant that I mentioned earlier, in this particular case, the one that's going to be the one of main concern for us is HCl, hydrogen fluoride. Potential emissions are 8.2 tons per year. They're going to be using that sorbent injection that I mentioned earlier, which also controls SO2 emissions, to get that number down to below 10 tons per year. A lot of questions I think people have about the burning of the sludge. Once again, I do want to point out that the wood fire is going to be about 600 million BTUs per hour. The sludge fire rate is right around 4 million BTUs per hour, so it doesn't make up a large portion of the raw material that will be going into this facility. But I know that it's a concern for the folks, and so I want to kind of go over, based on EPA numbers, we calculated how much heat input they would use and multiplied that by EPA emission factors. The emission factors that EPA has developed for sewage sludge incineration. And kind of put those in here to kind of give you a sampling of the emissions we expect from the sludge. Particulate matter, less than a ton per year. Sulfur dioxide, right at a ton per year. Nitrogen oxide is right over 4 tons per year. I did want to point out that these values here are incorporated in that 247-ton cap. So it's not in addition to that cap this facility would have. It becomes part of that. NOx, VOC, right around 4 tons per year. Carbon monoxide, right around 5 tons per year. HCl and all other caps combined, less than 1 ton per year. I did want to talk about some other biomass fire facilities we have in our Georgia. There's plenty of them around here. George Power Plant Mitchell over in Albany, they have proposed to convert their coal-fired boiler, which is right around 100 megawatts, turn it into a biomass fire facility. In addition to that, we have six other fairly recently permitted biomass power plants that have been permitted around the state. They're all similar in size, roughly somewhere between 30 to 100 megawatts all around the state. We have one over in Clay County is another facility that's a little bit bigger, permitted to be a little bit bigger than this one here, and that's Yellow Pine. I did want to point out that all paper mills burn scrap wood to generate energy. The one right here in town does, the ones over on the coast. They've got the wood there, it's a good source of fuel for them. And so I just want to point out that paper mills are, burning wood for energy is not new to this particular project. I want to go over where we are in the status of the air quality review. Permit, we did post the permit online as a courtesy to folks. Because this is not a PSD or a Title V permit yet, typically we would not post that permit online. But because we have public interest, we went ahead and did that. The permit is still in rough draft form. I have not done my review on that yet. I'm not sure if John's completed his review on that permit or not. So we're not getting ready to issue this permit tomorrow. We've still got some work to do on it, but I wanted to give you an example of what the permit may be looking like.